This is episode 62 of the After Gambling Podcast. In this episode, I'm going to give you a strategy that I like to use that helps me to challenge my thoughts and just overall become a better thinker. Hey there, and welcome to the After Gambling Podcast. My name is Jamie. I'm a former problem gambler. Now I haven't gambled in nearly 10 years, July 15th of 2010. It's hard to believe. As I record this, yesterday was February 13th, and that was 3,500 days. So the whole one day at a time mantra, 3,500 times. So today is 3,501. And today, as I record it, just happens to be Valentine's Day. So this is going to be an episode about showing love and spreading love. But doing so in a little bit different way. So there's your hook. Stay with me, and we'll be talking about that here in a little bit. But first, I want to show some love and some appreciation to just all the messages that I've gotten. I had all those requests in one of the last episodes, and you guys have just been great. I've gotten so many messages of support and saying, hey, I listen to the podcast, and it's helped me with this area of my life. There's just been so many cool messages. I don't want to bring any single one up because they've just been all so cool. And also I've gotten tremendous support, for the podcast, which has been really, really cool. It's humbling every time I kind of open my email and see, hey, somebody took the time to support the show, whether it's the email, or the other ways. And if you want to look and check out the ways you can help out, ways you can support the show, you can go to aftergambling.com/support, and that will take you to the page. And there's some books that I really like that you can click on, that you can get and pick up and help further your self-development. And there's some other ways that you can support the show. The one that I think I asked about last time, but I'm going to continue to push, is, hey, if you can leave a review, especially on iTunes, leave a review, give a rating, a 5-star rating. Just went over 100 5-star ratings, and there's one 1-star rating. So, hey, I'm pretty sure that person just clicked on the wrong button. They really meant 5-star. They probably just accidentally clicked 1. It got submitted because I had that perfect score. But yeah, if you want to throw on a review or just give it a rating, that would be awesome. It helps people find the show, and that really helps, just other people to find this and helps us grow. And that's the last thing. Holy cow, y'all. We went over 100,000. We're not stopping. I jokingly said 1 million is next. And this month alone, we're going to go over 10,000 easily. So craziness. Thanks for listening. I'll keep showing up and keep doing this. And I appreciate you keep tuning in and listening to me talk and be bringing some people on. So it's not just me talking in the next couple episodes. So look forward to that. Now, in the open, I teased with the hook that this will be an episode about furthering your thinking, challenging your thinking, your thoughts, and how that can benefit you in life after gambling and just life in general. This is one of those things that I've kind of picked up on along the way, and it's been through a lot of self-examination. But it's the concept, and that's why I kind of tie it in with Valentine's Day, is showing some love to other people. And it doesn't mean on social media, a lot of times we'll say it through likes, right? We'll throw a heart here. As my daughter says, I want to do a heart on that one on Instagram. Or on Twitter, it's likes. And so often, and I've catch myself doing this, there's things that I tend to agree with. The things that I agree with as I'm scrolling, right? What do? We hit like. We hit like. We hit like. And I think that's cool. It's cool to kind of see those other views, kind of give some support for those other views to say, yeah, we kind of agree with this. But the thing that I've found when I really dig deep is that the number of people, when people like a post, it's cool just because it kind of, like I say, it shows that other people think the same way. But it's not where I grow the most. And for people that follow me on Twitter, you maybe saw me tweet this out earlier this morning, was that when I really look at it, I'm thankful mostly for people when I see opposing views, and especially when people take the time in a comment thread that I'm in, or if I post something, or I talk about something, or if they send an email about an episode that is in disagreement or bringing up a different point of view. It doesn't always have to be disagreement, But that's been something that almost all of my growth, all of my development and I like to think of myself as a pretty good thinker. I challenge my thoughts all the time, sometimes too much. It would be nice to just kind of get one thing in my head and stick with it for a long time. But my pursuit of improvement and my pursuit of better, I like to hear what other people have to say. And so anytime somebody takes the time to respond to something with a different point of view, it helps me. And I really try not to go into quick defense mode to argue my side of it. We're all guilty of that. We all do that. I'm not going to stand here and say that I don't do that as well. But I do try in so many times to understand where the other person's coming from. Get a feel for what their background is. What's their familiarity with the topic? Why is it? And then curious. Why do they have this different view? What are they seeing in the same set of circumstances and situations that I'm not seeing? And normally, it's not that hard to kind of see how they come to a different conclusion or a different thought on something given the same set of kind of factors that we're both looking at, but through our own unique lenses, because we all have different unique views of the world and experiences. And I'm a big believer that we're all shaped by our experiences. And it's those experiences that dictate how we see the world and our thoughts for how the world should act and how it should be. But as I said, when I really look at it, all of my growth, my development, I mean, we started with this podcast. We started Gambling Still Sucks. And there were episodes about operators that probably weren't very nice. And I still believe probably a lot of the things that I said back then. But I've also gotten to know some people that work on operations. And some of my thoughts that I had before, they've brought up valid points. It's, you know what, that's not exactly true. And here's why. And I've sat and I've listened to them and I've tried to not always interject myself into the conversation, but be the fly on the wall when people are talking about something that I'm really curious about. Because I'm like, man, I don't know that I agree with this, but I'm going to follow it. I'm going to try and understand the line of thinking. And it's benefited me. And a lot of times it has changed my views because there's a good point there that I just wasn't seeing. And once I see it, I'm like, well, yeah, that's logical. That's reasonable. Makes sense. I don't have anything to say back to that. That's a good thing. And I try to adopt that on and say, okay, this is going to alter my view. And it doesn't mean that I completely change my thoughts or the outcome, but it definitely does help me to make a better decision. Or if nothing else, and this is the best part of all, is when you see what other people are saying, even if at the end of it, you completely disagree with it, it helps you to verbalize and to explain your point by knowing theirs. So even in a case where I follow it and I still come to a completely different belief on what the next step is, I can do so with this new knowledge and this new insight that further helps me to explain my point of view and maybe to address that other point of view. So like I said, with this being Valentine's Day, this is all about just kind of showing people love and showing people, giving them some grace that maybe they have a different point of view. Maybe they have a different perspective on things. And we all do. And there's so much value to that. I don't think it would be valuable if we all thought the same things. There's some people that I really respect and we often comment and say, we're not going to agree on everything. And that's especially why we should work together. Because we are going to challenge each other. We're going to stand up and say, you know what? No, Jamie, I see what you're saying there. And I understand why you're saying it. But here's something I don't think you're thinking about. And when we step back, obviously, this is extremely important in the whole gambling landscape, right? You have operators on one side, regulators on another side, former problem gamblers on the other side. And you have all these sides, right? I don't know if you can have, three sides? Yeah, you can have a triangle. You can have multiple sides. See, I just kind of wing this thing. And that's the one thing I'm trying to do a little bit more is not edit this thing down too much. So you're going to hopefully get a little bit more of me just kind of free flowing of thoughts and ideas. So hopefully it puts a smile on your face every now and then when I realize, okay, how many sides can you have? Hey, we can have an octagon. We can have 8 sides. So we have all these different sides. And the only time that this doesn't work, and unfortunately it's fairly common, is when those sides plant their flag in the ground and they say, this is where we are. You can come meet us here, but we're not moving. And hopefully and I already see this with the collaboration, that more and more people are collaborating across those lines, those party lines, if you're talking politics. So it's definitely something that's important as we try and figure out what are some best next steps to take when we're addressing problem gambling, gambling harm. But again, this podcast is all about just improving your life as well. This can work with a spouse. This can work with kids. This can work with bosses and coworkers. And trust me, it's not always fun. I would like to just be right and for them to be wrong, and to have my point of view be valid and theirs be completely wrong, and just them grovel and say, no, yeah, you're right. We're going to do things your way. But that makes you a tyrant. And I don't think people really like being around tyrants. And so this is something, take this out into your other areas of your life. Give people some grace. Try to meet them to understand. It doesn't mean you have to agree, but you have to try and meet them in a place where you can both understand each other. And showing that little bit of love, showing that little bit of grace. Like I say, it's the one thing that's made me a better thinker. And it's some of the best deep philosophical debates. And they're not even debates, they're discussions that I get into these days are with people when they push back. And I really appreciate those people. There's some that I'm in these all the time, and they'll know who they are. And we kind of message back and forth with these kind of deep discussions, and we're kind of pushing back on each other's thoughts. And we're saying, hey, you know what? I kind of get that. I can see that. But what about this? And what about this? And there is this thinking out loud that we permit each other the space and the grace to talk in a way that we're not going to offend each other, but we're also going to state our views and try to understand the other person's views. So this Valentine's Day, and looking at how the world is sometimes, it's easy to fall into these party lines, these groups, these sides. I mean, just this last week, if you're following the news, we had team recline your seat on the airplane and team reclining seats should never happen. And I'm going to give you grace to tell me why you should recline your seat. And then I'm going to tell you that, no, you're wrong. I am team no recline. There's no reason to have reclining seats. I love that when I have my laptop out in the seat all of a sudden and I'm basically eating my laptop because it's so close. I can't even, I'm like T-Rex trying to type on my computer because it's jammed up into my chest. I'm 6'1". I'm a big guy. My knees are all getting crammed in. Now I got my laptop and I'm literally typing away with my T-Rex arms and the screen is slanted down. So I'm having to duck down to see what I'm typing on the airplane. It's really, really fun. So yes, if you're in front of me on the airplane and you recline, now know that I may retaliate with the guy like he did, just constantly jiggling the seat nonstop for however long our flight is. No, but aside from that, aside from whether to recline your seat or not, all these things, give some people some grace. You also get grace in return. That's one of the beautiful things. When you give out grace, you get a little bit back and people are more willing to hear you out, to understand your thoughts and your opinions. And like I say, at the end of the day, all this stuff is great because it makes us better thinkers and it allows us to grow. So take this, apply it into your life, apply it into your gambling. Challenge, question things. I question things all the time. I question things about GA. I question things about podcasts, about things I do, things I see people doing. I don't question them directly about it because I think it's their own damn business. But if they ask me, I will tell them. But all these things, just be questioning, looking for areas to explore, dive deep, give people grace, hear them out. And yeah, I'm a little bit hippie. I'd like to see us all sort of get along a little bit better. And even if we come to different conclusions, which we should, let's just have a little bit of respect for each other. Be kind. It doesn't cost anything to be kind. You can disagree, but be kind about it. And try to understand the other point of view because you never know. You may be wrong. And I'll close this up by saying that I've been wrong. I've been wrong at least 2 or 3 times in my life. I can't even say that with a straight face. I've been wrong so many times in my life, it's not even funny. But again, the key is to learn from those. Don't double down on wrongness. Doubling down. That's the other thing. How many things there are that are gambling related just in general talking in the phrases that we use in our life. I mean, betting on things, doubling down. It's interesting to me. That's when I stop gambling. Some of these terms, I'm like, man, should I use those terms anymore? But yeah, it's part of our language, I suppose. So yeah, don't double down on those thoughts that might get you in trouble later, because you may be wrong. So I hope you're enjoying season 4 of the podcast, all about personal development, growth, life after gambling. And I know a lot of people have asked me, hey, you know what? You should do some podcasts in some other areas. And I think that's what this sort of is. I'm also going to be doing one on fatherhood. So if you want to check that out, you can check that one out. There's just kind of a starter episode up there right now, but it's something that I want to get better at and improve. And I see how much better I've gotten just by talking and being able to explain my thoughts on this podcast as it comes to gambling. And so I'm going to be doing one on fatherhood. So Dad Cooks Bacon is the name of the project. You can find that on iTunes. Like I say, there's just one episode up there which kind of outlines what I'm going to be doing with it. But I'm hoping to record some new episodes for that, be recording more episodes for this. Things are good. Still dealing with some crazy stuff from when I gambled 15 years ago when I decided to buy a condo using money that was based on my income as a gambler and poker money. Don't do that. Very bad decision, but hopefully I'll be clearing that up. But aside from those little hiccups, life is good because I don't gamble and because I'm just honest with my life now. And like I say, just trying to be better. And I know because you're listening to this, you're trying to be better too. And I commend you. I tip my cap to you because it's hard, but it's worth it. So that's going to be it for today. And finally, remember, I'm not a doctor. I'm not a lawyer. I'm not any of those things that have letters before or after my name. So please seek out professional help. I tell people this was designed to be a bridge. This is a bridge to help you get on the path to stopping gambling and changing your life. But this isn't the entirety of it. So definitely seek out professional advice early. You'll regret it if you don't. The sooner you get it, all of a sudden you'll look back and say, man, that wasn't so bad. I should have done that earlier. So definitely seek out help. There's a lot of great therapists out there that are just waiting for you to come in. They've done this. They've seen it. They can help you out quite a bit. Same with finances. Talk to your doctor also. Mental health stuff. Hey, we all have our struggles. It's nothing new. It's nothing to be embarrassed about. Please reach out to your doctor and get the help that you deserve. And then finally, music for the show is Something Elated by Broke for Free. It's hopefully playing in the background right now as I say this. Really cool music. It's licensed under the Creative Commons license. That's it. If you want to support the show, aftergambling.com/support. Leave me some reviews on iTunes and keep shooting me messages. I appreciate y'all. This is great. Enjoy it. It's so nice to be back in this routine. And I will see you in the next episode.